Let's continue our course with the repair of this water damage device. Next, we'll see the steps necessary to save it. He's gonna try to fix this device and he will show you the method we are applying for these water damage devices. According to the information provided by our customer, he attempted to remove the back cover and he ended up breaking it. As I said before, we always have to pay attention to the details. This security sticker is intact, which means that the device has not been opened at the top. On the other hand, the sticker at the bottom part is broken. To reach the motherboard, we have to remove these screws. Before removing any connector, we have to remove the battery flex. In this way, we avoid possible short circuits on the motherboard. We continue removing the cameras and the coaxial cable. With great care, we remove the motherboard. Here we've got another clue. Practically, this part of the shielding is burned. Surely, there is a strong short circuit just below. In this area, I think we've got the PMIC. We remove the screws from below to reach the charging module. Now, with the help of the microscope, we analyze the motherboard looking for signs of humidity. Here we've got a good short circuit, so we have to remove the shield. We clean this connector using contact cleaner. According to what I'm seeing, the greatest damage in this device is below this shield. We continue with our visual inspection of the motherboard on the other side. Now we are going to check the charging module. These solder bolts are here because of the heating process. It might be that the client has used the device after getting wet, or it might be that he was charging the device with a low quality charger. As I was teaching you before, we are going to remove the shield at 450 Celsius degrees and 80% air. The trick is to lift it in the shortest possible time, because in this way the CPU and the memory will not get too hot. To distribute the temperature well, I'm not using the nozzle. Remember that you have to move it all the time so the heat is distributed well. And also, these shields are very well soldered. Now, with the help of the microscope, we'll see the damage. All the damages caused by the humidity is near to PMIC. In this area, we've got the inputs and outputs of the voltage. The water will look for the areas with higher voltages and the shortest path to the ground. Here, everything is burned. We are going to try to find the solution. We'll clean this area using contact cleaner and a little bit of cotton. If the device presents water damages in a specific area, we do not have to do a total cleaning. We just have to try to cure this area. If the corrosion resists, we use a clean cloth with a metal brush. In this way, all the dirt will be trapped in the cloth. Also, let me tell you that in the description of this video, you'll have all the tools that we are using in our workshop. So, if you need anything, just take a look. Now, we go back to the microscope to analyze the area. Now we are going to do some measurements quickly. With the multimeter in continuity mode, we are going to measure some capacitors and some inductors. This capacitor is not well. One pad has to be connected to the ground and the other pad to a voltage line. These three capacitors are well. Surely, because of some burnt capacitor, the whole line is to ground. Another capacitor is in a short circuit. Now, we apply a little flux and we use a precision air station to remove these two capacitors. By my point of view, these two capacitors have lost their properties. We use a GBC air station at 350 Celsius degrees and 50% air. After removing the two capacitors, we have to clean the area. As you can see, the short is gone, so we are going to check the device. As it is this type of capacitors, the device has to work. Then we can solder the missing components. To know the value of the capacitors, we have to open the schematic tool. We are going to clean the solder balls with the help of this metal brush. In this way, we have managed to remove most of the solder balls. Now, we'll assemble our device and check it to see if it works properly. Here you can see that our device is charging, but right now it does not have enough battery, so I will leave it a little bit in charge. Our device has a good charge of 1.6 amperes. Guys, this was the way we have given a solution to this water damaged Xiaomi.